Hi guys, how are you? Welcome back. Today we will continue our lecture number 3. This lecture is related to the HSE tools, and as we know that we have discussed before in our previous lectures about the HSE tools, PTW and GSA. Now we will continue our lecture number 3, and it's the part number 3 of the HSE tools, and this lecture is about stop. Actually, when you talk about the stop, it doesn't mean that you have to stop or halt somewhere, but it is actually about safety training observation program, as it is written on the board. Stop, there is a combination of 4 words. These 4 words are STOP. It is called safety training observation program. It is developed by DuPont, and it is a program to control the hazards in your workplace. And there is a complete cycle for it, which helps you out to identify your hazards and make a remedial action against them. But how can you perform this tool in the operational activities? It is in the form of a small card, a written card where you observe whatever you observe as a hazard, consider as a hazard in the form of unsafe act and unsafe condition. So we will continue, and we will start from here. Actually, what is a stop? It's a safety training observation program. It is a program designed to control the hazards in the workplace by implementing or by observing the hazards in the workplace, which will later on helps you out to make a remedial action, and you can control the workplace hazards. Why it is designed? I already told you that it is designed to control the hazards in the workplace, but whenever you are observing something or observing in your workplace the hazards, so there should be some means of communication, of communicating these hazards to some other people. But if you observe by your own self and do not let other people know about these hazards, it's a mistake by you. So whenever you are working in an organization and you are doing some operational activity, you must need to make it sure that whatever the hazard you have observed, do not make it hide. Because if you hide this hazard, maybe some other person comes in contact with this type of a hazard and he get an injury. So you consider yourself a responsible person at that time, because you ignore this thing, you hide this thing to prevent yourself or to prevent the activity which is going in the wrong way, to think about this thing that maybe I will be punished or my salary will be cut or I have a detection or I have a punishment. So you stop this thing. But whenever you observe anything which is going wrong, apply your efforts, apply your power and apply your mind behavior to make this thing correct, so that the other persons who are working in the same workplace with you may not encounter these type of the hazards. And maybe if you ignore this thing, maybe you not encounter a danger, but the other person who is working with you, he ignore this thing and he come in contact with this type of the hazard, then he can have an injury. So try to prevent these things at the workplace. Do not hide any kind of a hazard if you observe in the operational activity. So now we move on. First of all, it's a reporting system in the form of the observation card. Whenever you observe anything wrong in an organization, there is a system developed by the HSE management system. In this management system, this is in the written form of a written, in the form of the written document that you have observed something, you have write it and report it to the senior authority so that they can take action against it and make a corrective action against it, so that in the near future it will not happen again. So in this stop program, safety training observation program, there are 2 things which are very much important and you need to know about this thing, so that you can easily identify how to identify the hazard, how to clarify the hazard, and how to report it in the form of the stop card. There are 2 things. One is unsafe act, another is the unsafe condition. What is an unsafe act? Unsafe act means that a person has been trained for something or for an operational activity, that this type of the operation you need to follow these procedures, but he try to unfollow the procedures and he try to bypass the things to preserve the time, and he knows that this thing I am doing is wrong, but he actually do. So this is considered as a unsafe act. For example, you are driving on the road, taking an example of the motorway, you are driving on the road, you are driving at a speed of 140 kilometers per hour, but actually the speed over there is 120. So it means that you know that the speed which is mentioned on the road is 120 kilometers, but you are driving at 140 kilometers, 20 kilometers ahead of 120 kilometers. So this is a mistake by you. This is an unsafe act you do. This is by your own self. You know that I am doing wrong, but you are still doing it. This is unsafe act. What is an unsafe condition? Unsafe condition is that something is in front of you is wrong. You think it is wrong. This is an unsafe condition. For example, there is a heater. You do not attach a plug with it, but you put these two wires into the socket. This is an unsafe condition because this condition can make an electrical spark. This condition can cause an electrical shock to the employee. So this condition, you know that this is wrong, and you have to make it right by applying the control measures, by applying a plug to that wires. This is an easy job. But if you do it by your own self, you know that this is wrong, this becomes an unsafe act. For example, there is some oil spillage on the road, there is a chance that you can slip. This is an unsafe condition. And if you by your own self drop the oil on the ground to let other persons to slip on the ground, this is an unsafe act. So difference between unsafe condition and unsafe act is that if a person knows and have an awareness that this thing is unsafe, but he still try to do it, so this is unsafe act. And if some wrong condition you observe in front of you, which can in the near future will make a near miss, will result in an event, the consequences of which may be a fatality. So this condition need to be improved, need to be the corrective action need to be taken against it to make it proper and make a remedy and to make it safe for the future working. Now we go towards the other thing, stop cycle. This is very important thing. When you learn about the stop cycle, you can easily write a stop card. Later on, I will make a picture of this stop card easily. This is more easy for you. First of all, in this cycle, you have to decide. You have to decide what things you have to observe. There are many operational activities going over at your workplace. You go over there just like an inspector or just like an auditor and just check the things which are going wrong. You observe, maybe you will observe unsafe condition, maybe you will observe unsafe acts. So this is your first part. You have to decide what to do. You need to make an inspection. This is your first part. Second part here, the stop means not safety training observation program. This means you need to halt at that place. For example, a person is doing a welding job at a specific location. You stop near him, you observe his activity, what he is doing. Either he is doing the operation in a safe manner, either he is doing the operation in the unsafe condition or unsafe act, and making his act as unsafe. Maybe he is not applying the same procedures which are need to be applied to make the operation safe. So you need to observe it. Stop for 30 seconds and then you go for observation. Observation, after the observation, there is another step which is called act. Act means your action. In multi organizations, when you are working with many people, every person have different attitude and behavior. So if your way of giving him the instruction is positive, for example, you can say him that please do this thing in the right way, in this manner, this is the following procedures, you have to follow this. But if you say him like this, do it like this, this is the wrong behavior. The words, the things you want to do is the same. You are asking him to do the thing in this way, but your way of talking is not good. Maybe this thing at that time make his behavior wrong, make his consideration a negative, in the negative way. Maybe he will go for negative towards you, that this guy is not good, why he not tell me like this. So whenever you are working in the multi organizations, and when you are any organization, when you are working, your way of talking should be positive, your approach should be positive. You have to correct the things rather than to make it worse. by your attitude. So first of all, when you have to correct him, when you make him feel that he is doing wrong and this is the right way to do it, but to let him approach through positive attitude. Do not pass a statement which is negative to him and which will disturb him and which will make him angry to you. So try to avoid this thing in the organization. When talking to some person, come with the emotions, play with the person emotions and provide him with a positive attitude. The results of the outcomes or the outcomes results or the outcomes of the unsafe work which he is doing in the operational side. This is the reporting. Report, how to report. There is a specific format for the stock card. In this stock card format, in every organization, the same formats are using. There are little changes in that format, but actually the same format is utilized in every organization. What is this format? There is a description of the event which you observe. For example, a person is doing a welding job, he is not wearing the safety goggles, he is not using the welding mask, he is not properly placed the oxygen cylinder and the acetylene cylinder, he has not installed the flashback arresters in the welding operation, he not have the permit, he not have conducted the GSA for the operation, he don't have the barrication, he don't have the fire extinguishers in front of him to extinguish the fire in case there is a fire incident. This is the description. Then the next column comes with the corrective action. What you think is a corrective action? He need to have a fire extinguisher with him which is properly filled and which is efficient for working. He need to place the cylinders a distance from each other. He have to install the flashback arrester. He have to issue a PTW. He have to conduct a GSA for the same operation, for the operational activity. So this is the right way to report it. But whenever you are reporting on the stock card, do not mention the name of the person. Because if this person observes you that you are mentioning the name of him, he will feel bad for you. Secondly, do not write the stock card in front of the person whenever you observe an unsafe act or unsafe condition. Here you can correct him. This is not the way to correct him, to report in front of him. This is the place in the stock cycle where you can correct him positively with a positive approach. And do not consider that whenever you are reporting a stock card, it's a punishment for that person. It's not a punishment for this person. It is the way to correct the unsafe condition and correct the unsafe acts for the person so that such kind of the events not reoccur. This is the way to report a stock card. This is the whole cycle for the stock card. Actually, the basic purpose of the stock card is to control the hazards in the workplace by identifying the hazards and then reporting it. Report is the evidence for you. How this evidence works for you? Against this, you make a remedial action plan. What is a remedial action plan? This is, in other words, you can call it a corrective action plan. Corrective action plan, you can write the description of that event which you observe. You can apply the target dates over there, you can apply the responsible person over there, and you can check it later on because you have a tracker register with you. This is called a tracker register, this is called a corrective action plan in different organizations with different names. When you call it by remedial action plan, it is same. When you call it by corrective action plan, it is same. When you call it by hazard tracker register, because when you mention the hazards and you given the target dates and you assign the responsibilities with the respective person, you can easily identify that this hazard, or you can observe it later on by inspection that this hazard is controlled or not. If it requires management resources, you can ask the management to give us resources to resolve this issue. If you need manpower, you can ask some management. If you need operational SOPs to be changed, you can ask operational department. So there, these things are originally lined up when you give the target dates and when you assign the responsibilities to the specific persons, so that you can easily fulfill the needs and can make the issue resolved in the timely manner. So this is all about the stock cycle. I hope so that you have understand. Again, reminding you about the stock cycle. Please see clearly about the stock cycle or write it on the paper. And this original thing, who developed it, what is the purpose and how it is applied, what is unsafe act and unsafe condition. These four or five things, when you understand, you can easily report on the stock card. Thank you guys. I hope so that you enjoyed the lecture, and I need your comments. and further questions, so that I can reply in a timely manner for your ease of access. Thank you guys. Thank you.